this panel exclusively with me. We have a diverse group of individuals. All have more than almost two decades of experience in their own fields, and that makes them very apt for a panel that wants to talk about creating the billion-dollar business with a billion-dollar valuation in mind. The panel will talk about four crucial things today, centered around funding. But the first important point that we're going to be dissecting is how to really build a business of this generation. Like Mr. Katyal said, that today businesses have to be built with certain expectations in mind. I'll first take his comments on how businesses of today are being made and what kind of business vision one needs to build before really creating these businesses of today, of digital India.
So, you know, digital is the key word, right? Everybody wants a digital business. There can be other businesses, and there are people on the panel who do far better businesses than digital businesses. But unfortunately, you know, digital is the darling of the day. You know, when we look at building businesses, one of the first things that, you know, all of you must look within yourselves to say that whether you have the passion to do what you want to do. I think it's easier to want to do it, but if you really have to get down and get your hands dirty, what will come between you and your success will be the quantum of passion you have. And that really defines not only the success of the business, but success of you as an individual. What happens sometimes is that you have a great idea, you have passion for some years, you kick it off quite well, and then you lose the passion. The idea becomes really big over a period of time, but you don't own the idea any longer because you lost the passion, the perseverance, and the resilience to stay with it. And like he said, the first 1,000 users are critical. You'll also get to the first 100,000 and the first million, but then the million to 10 million to 100 million to that billion journey requires a serious amount of resilience and perseverance. Also, I think the other big deal about all of this is how much you're willing to put yourself into it and how much you're willing to dirty your hands around what you do. We want great funding. We want angel funding. We want, you know, Series A, Series B, so on and so forth, right? But the one thing that everybody looks for is your ability to navigate the circumstances yourself, right? You will move from Series A to whatever on only if the investor can see the passion and the commitment that you bring to the table. And that comes down to your obsession with your users and your customers. I think that in today's world is extremely, extremely critical. Users are very, very unforgiving and they have seriously low patience. You can be a startup, but the user doesn't care.
Sure.
Right? You cannot put a scroll over there saying, I'm a startup, I'm just starting off, please treat me well. Right? Unfortunately, it doesn't work like that anymore. There are too many options. There are too many, you know, multiple choices that users are living with. And so your obsession, and use the word obsession, with your users will get you somewhere. And will also let you create newer and new white spaces, newer and newer use cases. Because the other thing that happens is that, and like in our business, in any other business, is that if you come up with a great idea, it only takes about 12 to 14 to 18, not months, but weeks, for somebody to replicate that. And you're back to being equal with everybody else. And so your ongoing obsession will keep you far ahead than the others.
Sure. It's an important point in building businesses when we speak about the passion, and this passion can easily be filtered by an angel investor or an investor who's sitting on the other side of the table, who, like very aptly Mr. Katyal said, that in the cycle of the business, the founder or the creator really forgets what the business was being built for. It's a long journey, of course, we understand that. But in your view, How does a startup or a startuppreneur need to look at their business, keeping their passion in mind? Because we hear a lot of jargon around passion, but businesses are not built on passion. They are built on money and consecutively on customers.
Well, I think you have pitted me against him. No, but that's a very valid point, because two, three points. One is, passion is needed. And passion is needed not just for the idea or the original idea, but to actually look at, depending on the facts of the day, how you need to modify it, how you tune it, to then continue and relook at the whole passion, the whole idea again and again and again. So in the morning I was saying, it needs quite a bit of perseverance.
Completely echo what the two gentlemen have said, but I think for me, something much before the passion is the compelling vision. What is that need which you are, what is that problem you are trying to solve? What is the need you are trying to fulfill? And is it going to be transitory in nature, or is it a long-term need which will not get faded away with time? I think to me, that's the most important, followed by passion. Absolutely important, you've got to be mad for that. And then also getting a critical mass of a few people who share your aspirations. So unless these three things are combined, which is the need which you're trying to fulfill, followed by the passion, and creating that aspiration and a critical team of people, critical mass of those people who really set the ball rolling. I think that is something very, very clear. The second part is authenticity. There has to be authenticity. People do not want anymore to hear only stories.
And replicas.
Yeah, and lip service. People want authentic leaders. So I think these are the two things which have to come across very, very clearly. And then to say what Gulzar is saying, don't look at the billion, look at the first 1,000 customers, first 100, depending on which industry you are. First 100, first 1,000, first 100,000, everything else will follow.
Setting the vision right, we often hear in journalistic circles, investors tell us that, well, the idea is great, but startups are trying to solve problems that don't exist. And that's where the vision comes into picture. But how do you make your vision compelling enough for an investor to believe in it, or a global company such as Google to agree in, on the idea? Mr. Azad, I would like your comments on that.
Sure. I think this is very, very interesting discussion, and I'm hoping you were paying attention to what everyone said here, because it's important in, you know, different aspects of your life. So I think the point on passion was made, and that's very important. The point of differentiating passion and vision was made. That's also very important. I think there's a question of how do you translate, right, your vision and idea and take it forward. The one thing that I would like to say there is, and that's where I think the point that Kamal was making on, you know, having a vision, is to be able to separate your interests or things that you would love to do from the things that is needed to be done, right? And even when you come up with an idea, I think the most important thing is to think about what you can do, right? The doing part is the most important part of it. Is, you know, there are things that I would say, I would rather go on a different note and say, there are things that you should not do. Like, for example, I said, don't focus on the whole $1 billion thing. Don't focus on, even on investing. Like this whole thing about, you know, you have to get angel funded and you have to get Series A and Series B. You will soon understand when you get to the market. But actually, that's also all staged. You know, there is an entire ecosystem that actually wants you to believe that is all required. Actually, if you, at the beginning of your journey, of an impactful journey, if you bring everything down to just 1P, and that 1P is not pricing, is not promotion, is not positioning, is not marketing, is not how you communicate, is actually product. if in a world, and this is a different world, right, from the one that used to exist, you know, a few decades back. This is a world of technological movement. This is a world of technology transformation, of everybody having access to technology and resources. I think in that world, you have to think about, you know, bringing it down to that single P. And, you know, of course, if your idea applies to a service, you know, it stands for the service, but you bring it down to the product. And everything else will follow. And, you know, whether you're creating that product, as I said, you know, for some first 1,000 users or first 100,000 users, you know, this was actually a very interesting conversation that happened in the early days between Google and, you know, I think Samiran will help me with that. Who's the person who invented the 4 P's? Kotler, right? So Philip Kotler was there in one of the conferences, and actually a Google person who was an early day product person walked up to him and said that, I think you are flawed in your belief. He said, you know, I don't understand.
I've been teaching that for like decades now, and I've written books about it. That Google actually was created not on these 4 P's. Although you were talking about it here in our conference, I think you've got it wrong. Of course, Philip Kotler was taken aback. But then that person explained, Google was not created on this concept. And if Google was created on this concept, Google would have never succeeded. Google was created by just discarding every other pain and getting to the product. It did not worry about positioning, and that is why it was able to reinvent its industry. It did not worry about packaging or pricing. That's why pricing and investments and dollars followed Google's products, not the other way around. And time has come for India to get into that zone and start thinking differently from what investors are telling us, start thinking differently from what our books are telling us,
sure.
And start thinking differently from the already existing models, and think about the product, because now we have enough technology innovation to think about that.